Good afternoon. It's Chef Drama, Chef Taylor. I know it's late. I was just up and about and I thought, let me go on and just speak to everyone. I haven't been on in a while. I've been kind of busy, but of course I'm Chef Taylor, Chef Drama from Next Level Chef Season 2. And of course I'm all keto. Everyone knows that I'm totally sold out for keto. So if you're just tuning in, if you've not been following me, many of you know I've lost 147 pounds doing keto lifestyle. I'll show you some of the things that I've used throughout the course of my 4-year journey, losing 147 pounds. However, most of the weight came off. Hello, Simply Desire, Desi. Simply Desi. I was about to say simply, I don't know what I was about to say, but how are you guys? Good to see you. Andre Butler, hello, hi. Remember to like, follow, and share. Daryl Taylor, Chef Drama, from Next Level Chef Season 2. Now, of course, I own a catering service here in Atlanta, Georgia. That's Epicurean Drama. You can follow me on Facebook, all social media platforms. I can't talk tonight. Daryl Taylor Chef Drama. There are two pages, Daryl Taylor Chef Drama, also Epicurean Drama Events. And I'm also the founder of Overflow End Stage Renal Foundation. Of course, after being on dialysis for over 17 years, I was kidney transplanted 4 years ago. Isn't that amazing? I received a gift of life. Hi, Tyranny. Hi there. Yeah, I received a gift of life, kidney transplant 4 years ago, November 17th of 2019. Changed my life. I'll be right back. Hang on just a second. Come on, baby. Let's go out. Come on. You want to go out? Come on. You want to go out? You want to go out. Okay. You don't want to go out? Okay. So getting back to what I was saying, remember to like, follow, and share. Daryl Taylor, Chef Drama, okay, on all platforms. Of course, I've lost 147 pounds on keto lifestyle. Now, of course, I lost almost 100 pounds the first 10 months. That's how much I'm sold out on this keto lifestyle. I'm going to show you one more picture. This is me at roughly, I would say almost 300 pounds. That's me with Jeanetta Cole, President Spelman, and a few other universities. I think she's might going into retirement now. Hi, Natasha, how are you? But I've lost over 147 pounds on this amazing, incredible keto lifestyle. And I've developed a barbecue sauce. Not forgetting to mention, let me just pull that up so I can show you the barbecue sauce. What was I thinking? Let me grab a bottle too. I'm gonna grab 3 bottles. Okay, now this is the barbecue sauce that I have created. It's Kickin' Country Keto. I'm gonna come just a little closer so you guys can actually see the barbecue sauce, okay? Can you see that? Can you see it? Kickin' Country Keto? I think I'll make it a little easier if I just get, you know what, I'll use a plate. That's what we'll do. Let me wake everyone up. That brings back memories. Okay. I will use a plate and put right there so we can get a good view of the sauce. Now, this sauce is available in the TikTok shop and also on Amazon for now. And soon it'll be available in local retail outlets. Now, not only is this Kickin' Country Keto barbecue sauce, there are some other sauces. There's Jammin' Jerk. That's not quite ready yet, but it's almost out there. And there's Poppin' Jalapeno Peach. That is not keto, but it is delightful. And also there's horsey honey mustard that is incredible. So those are some of the keto sauces. All are keto except for the poppin' jalapeno peach. Of course, peaches are not keto friendly. But these sauces, this one sauce right now is available on Amazon and also available in the TikTok shop. You can go right there in TikTok and get it. Hi there. Oh, thank you so much, Sugar Bones, Sugar Bones. I try my best, and I try and stay very humble because after being on dialysis, I was on dialysis for 17 years and received a gift of life November the 17th of 2019. And had I not received that kidney transplant, I would not have been able to do Next Level Chef with Gordon Ramsay, Naisha Arrington, and Richard Blaze. Oh my God, that experience totally changed my life to be able to meet Gordon Ramsay, Naisha Arrington, and Richard Blaze. Never did I ever dream in a million years that I would get such an opportunity to do such a thing. Forever grateful. However, talking about keto, and I'll tell you why I decided to do this keto lifestyle. Because after receiving the gift of life kidney transplant 4 years ago, I had actually gained a lot of weight because I had to take prednisone. And I actually ballooned back up to almost 290 pounds. So I went to the doctor and they were like, oh, the jam and jerk sauce is really, really good. I'll let you know. Remember to like, follow, and share Daryl Taylor, Chef Drama, and you will know when that sauce hits the market, okay? After going to the doctor for a regular checkup and realizing that I was pre-diabetic, they wanted to start me on medication that day. And I'm like, oh my God, no. If you can give me 30 days, I will get the weight off. And so my doctor gave me 6 weeks. Went back to the doctor and they were like, well, what are you doing? Hi, Sonia, how are you? Thank you for tuning in. Remember to like, share, and follow Daryl Taylor, Chef Drama. And after being told I was pre-diabetic, I thought, let me try and get this weight off. Went back 6 weeks later. And now, mind you, I asked my doctor, could I do keto? And she was like, no, you're not a candidate for keto because you're a kidney transplant patient, a recipient of an organ. So I'm like, oh my God, no. In my mind, I knew that I could modify the diet and still get the weight off and not consume all the dairy and all the protein protecting my kidney. So I did just that. I modified keto to fit my body type and all that was going on with me, and managed to lose the weight. So went back 6 weeks later and had lost like 24 pounds, I think, or 22. And she was like, what are you doing? I said, keto. And she's like, let me do your blood work. Check my blood work, everything was normal. So I guess being a chef and doing my research, knowing that I did not have to do all the protein and all the dairy and all the butter, I didn't have to do that. I could eat a sensible dinner and a sensible breakfast and all of that and just not eat a pound of bacon and all that crap. And so it has worked for me. And it can work for you if you modify it and not overdo it on the bacon and all that crap. And be mindful of what you're putting in your body. And then get some exercise. Now, I'll be honest with you. Initially, when I started being almost 300 pounds, I could not do a lot of exercise. However, after maybe 2 months into the program, the lifestyle, I began to do some exercising, walking around the neighborhood, walking the dog, stuff like that. And then eventually I started doing more. Oh, so you're on dialysis. I don't know. I think you can, but you know, you're probably already on a renal diet. So in my mind, I knew there were certain things that I could not eat, like being on a renal diet, you can't have tomatoes, so many things that you cannot have. And so many people don't realize what dialysis patients have to go through. And one thing about doing keto, you have to drink lots of water. And so I would say consult with your dietitian and your doctor being a renal on dialysis. So I don't want to tell you something because I'm not a physician, you know. So consult with your physician and your nutritionist and see how what they will tell you. I'm a end-stage renal disease transplant recipient of a kidney. And so I have to be very careful and not consume all the protein and all of the dairy, you know. So do your research and do what you think you need to do in order to get the weight off, you know. I would say you could do a keto, but I'm not a physician. But you have to keep in consideration, you have to drink water. And being a dialysis patient that's on dialysis now, the individual, I can't remember your name, you have to drink the water. And I'm going to show you how much water I could drink while on dialysis. Because some people just don't know. So I'm going to show you how much water that a dialysis patient can drink. When I was on dialysis, I could drink 4 ounces of water at a time. And you know this is very hard to do. And that's probably more than 4 ounces, maybe about 4 ounces. 4 ounces at a time. So now I don't have a problem drinking the water, because for all those 17 years, I could not drink water. So some of you are tuning in right now and you're not even drinking water. So why are you not drinking your water? Those things you take for granted until your doctor tells you don't drink water, because you will drown if you're a dialysis patient, because you can OD on water. So those little things I took for granted all of my life, I did take for granted. And the moment I was told that I had to do dialysis 17 years ago, I wanted water every single day. I wanted to just turn the jug up and just drink a gallon of water, you know. So those things, don't take for granted those little things. And you might have high blood pressure. You might have end-stage renal disease. You may have to be a diabetic. Drink water, flush your body, flush your system on a regular basis. Now, I will drink. Just gulp this up. I can never get enough water, you know. So don't take that for granted. And let me mention this. For 17 years, I was on dialysis. For 15 of those years, I did not urinate. I did not urinate. Can you imagine not using the bathroom for 15 years? Can you imagine that? That's the purpose of dialysis. There's a machine that filters the blood and dialysis. I mean, it really filters your blood, takes out all the waste and the toxins out of your blood so that you're able to live. Some people don't realize what dialysis is, but that's what it is. You know, so don't take that for granted. So I vowed, when I started keto, I thought I would do it for 2 weeks just to see what happened. And after removing the carbs and the sugar from my body, I began to just melt away. The fat was just started, the pounds just start shedding. The first week, I think I lost 6 or 7 pounds. The second week, another 6 or 7 pounds. And I'm like, oh my God, that was like 14 pounds in like 2 weeks. That was mind blowing to see the weight, the pounds just shed. So do your research. That's what I did. And allow Google to be your friend. And I'm turning because I want to show you some of the things that have helped me throughout the course of my journey. Now, there are groups on Facebook. I joined Keto for Beginners. There's another Keto for Beginners that are recipes. Just put keto in Facebook, and there's so many different sites that will come up that can be there to mentor you along the way. And certainly I'm here. You can always inbox me. And I have a dear sister. Her name is Betty Marrero in Memphis, Tennessee. Send her a friend request, TikTok, Instagram, and reach out to her. She's a nutritionist. And she helped me along the way. I know she got tired of me calling her. And then allow Google to be your friend. If there are questions you have, Google keto, keto vegetables, keto fruit, and all these products that will come up, all the fruits and all the keto fruits, berries, all berries, raspberries, strawberries, blueberries, any berry, anything that has natural sugar, like pineapple, grapes, oranges, apples, those are not keto friendly. So if you pull away from those things for, let's say, 2 weeks, and go for all berries for 2 weeks, and then Google keto vegetables, eat those vegetables, remove the flour from the diet and the sugar. In place of granulated sugar, use a monk fruit sugar. Now, this is the sugar that I use. It's a monk fruit and the gold. And there is one other sugar. I buy this on Amazon. You can go to LaConta, to their website, and get it from there, from Amazon or their website. And there's another sugar that I found. Let me grab it real quick. I just found this just yesterday at Costco. Whole Earth. Bought this at Costco. Same thing as the monk fruit, Whole Earth, and the gold. Now, I have tried this in the white. It's not good. I'm going to be honest with you. The white is not good, but the gold, you cannot taste the difference from a regular granulated sugar, okay? And I'm going to share some other things with you guys also. Just checking something. I'm baking. Yes. And I'm actually just doing a little meal prep for next week, for later in the week, and maybe a few days for next week. I'm making a salmon, and I'll cut that up and actually put it into containers. Meal prep is always good to do, so that when you get hungry, you have things in the refrigerator you can just pull out. You can get the monk fruit sugar. They might have it at Walmart, maybe Kroger, but I buy the one in the gold, monk fruit in the gold. It looks just like this. See the gold? It's brown. It's better than the white. The white has the aftertaste, but this is a Whole Earth monk fruit in the gold. Very, very tasty. I actually prefer this, the Whole Earth. Whole Earth or the monk fruit, LaConta. Either one, they're really, really good. And I'll share some other things with you too. Yes, you can freeze cook salmon. I do it all the time. And also, I actually make meatloaf. I make meatloaf, and instead of using Heinz ketchup, there is a. I actually made meatloaf, and I paired it with Yo Mama's ketchup, which is no sugar added, and I also put the Kickin' Country Keto barbecue sauce on it. I'll show you another. Now, this ketchup has no sugar added. Let me show you these. Here we go. Now this is Heinz ketchup. Has no sugar added. You can find this at Walmart, Kroger, Target, Publix. No sugar added. Heinz ketchup. And I mix it with my Kickin' Country Keto barbecue sauce. A perfect blend. I make the meatloaf and I put it in the containers, separate it, and I freeze it. And when I get hungry, I just saute some vegetables or whatever. Keto-friendly vegetables like anything green, spinach, kale, zucchini, summer squash, Brussels sprouts, broccoli, cabbage. I'm going to turn my monitor. It's not really working. So cabbage, you got onion, peppers, cabbage, broccoli. I mean, broccoli, cauliflower rice. I actually make mac and cheese out of the cauliflower rice. When I tell you good, oh my God. And I actually make the macaroni. I will take cauliflower rice, take your eggs, heavy cream, a little nutmeg. You know, it's the same way you traditionally make your mac and cheese. Same way. A little ricotta, a little cottage cheese, whatever cheeses you're gonna use, cheddar, blend it all up, bake it, a little nutmeg. Yum! It is tasty. Oh my God. I'm just visualizing it. All those ingredients. And sometimes I make put a little smoked Gouda in it. When I tell you something that's incredibly delicious, it will blow your mind. I love that dish. Make it really pretty often because I like to freeze it. You know, I don't cook all the time. And people think being a chef that I'm in the kitchen. No, I don't cook every day. I will make something maybe once or twice a week, separate it, freeze it, pull it out. And when I first started keto, I would use Factor Meals or any meal service and freeze them and just pull it out because I'm always working. So when I get home, the last thing I want to do is cook something. But you don't have to break the bank. Sometimes I go shopping at Aldi, Whole Foods. I don't break the bank all the time, so I don't even want to call out Whole Foods all the time. I'll go to Aldi, Kroger, Sprouts, Trader Joe's, just wherever. I shop because I want to get the best deals. So I don't want to break the bank while I'm keto shopping. And I'll show you, you don't have to do that. You don't have to go broke when you're trying to do this lifestyle. And I see so many people run to these name brand stores, breaking the bank. You don't have to do that. I didn't do it. So why would I encourage you to do such a thing, okay? I'm gonna grab something out of the oven and I will be right back. I don't want to burn my dish. I actually will let you see this, but I really don't want to because it's not garnished. And everyone knows I'm all about garnishing. Let me see. Let me just check. Actually, what I made was just a salmon, a fillet of salmon. And I'm gonna separate it and put it into little containers for next week. And what I'll do is just come in, not next week, maybe tomorrow, the next few days. And I'll just come in and just saute some vegetables and have that at least tomorrow and maybe the next day for lunch or for dinner. Who knows? Oh, thank you so much. And you make sure you go on Amazon and give us a review, okay? That sauce is really incredible. Let me say this. The reason I developed this sauce is because this is gonna tell you that you know this sauce is good, okay? Let me tell you why I developed this sauce. The reason I developed it is because I am originally from Memphis, Tennessee. And everyone knows Memphis It's all about barbecue and the blues. So, you know, it makes me really want to start singing the blues. Okay? It makes me want to start singing the blues. Everyone knows I'm from Memphis. And Memphis, I have barbecue in my jeans. You know what I mean? So that tells you this sauce is out of sight good. It has that peppery finish to it. Kicking Country Keto. And since I'm trying to think of a name for it, I'm like, I'm a country boy. So from Memphis, Tennessee. So I'm like, I like that peppery finish because it makes you want more. It makes you want more. Hi, Jackson. How are you? Where are you from? Thanks for tuning in. Remember to like, follow, and share Daryl Taylor from Next Level Chef Season 2 with Gordon Ramsay, Naisha Arrington, and of course, I was on Richard Blaze's team. And remember to catch Season 3 comes on Thursday. This Thursday, check your local listing. This sauce is available on Amazon and the TikTok shop. So make sure you go on and get you some and give a review once you get it and let me know how you like it. Thanks, Anne. Thank you so much. Thank you, Pinky. Thanks for tuning in. Where are you calling? I'm about to say, where are you calling from, Pinky? Pinky Coleman, where are you from? Remember to like, follow, and share, guys. It's all about keto for me. I've lost 147 pounds doing keto. And thanks for shopping. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh my God, Pinky, you know my mom was from Mississippi. She was from Sardis, Mississippi. And Arkansas is in the house. Thanks, Arkansas. And South Carolina. Oh my God, South Carolina. So you know a thing or two about barbecue. Oh my God. Nothing like the Kicking Country Keto Barbecue. And so we're all in talking about keto. And so that is the reason I developed this sauce, because I'm from Memphis, Tennessee. Memphis is all about barbecue and the blues, baby. And I do a little singing sometimes. Maybe tomorrow if you tune in, I might go to the piano and play you a song or two. I'm only joking, I'm not gonna play. Okay, so the sauce is available on Amazon and in the TikTok shop, and soon it'll be in the Walmart Marketplace. And remember to like, follow, and share. You will know exactly what stores it hits soon as it's about to hit local retail. Holly from Nashville is in the house. Holly 53 is in the house. So we're like neighbors. Oh yeah. Tennessee, Memphis, Tennessee. And now I'm in Atlanta, Georgia for the past 25 years. Hey, Angie is in the house. And you love the blues. Well, you know something about barbecue then if you love the blues. Okay. So, and another thing we made, spaghetti with rails. This has been open. Actually bought this at Aldi. I love Aldi, guys. And I'm sorry if I'm always talking about Aldi. That's because I love it. And the reason I love it, because everything is reasonably priced at Aldi. And I am not going to break the bank. Somebody's from Marietta. Ann. Hey, Ann. How are you doing? So we're like, you know, you're Aunt Lennon is in the house. Tucker. Okay. Rails is the best. Low carbs. Low sugar. This is the sauce to buy. Now let's talk spaghetti. Because you can have spaghetti on a keto lifestyle. I'm not calling it a diet. That's one thing I'm not going to say it's a diet, because it's not. It's a lifestyle. So, we're talking spaghetti. I found this. But before I found this, I used to use a tofu pasta. And a dear friend, Chris Foy, chef, told me about this pasta. And so I ran out and bought it. Natural heaven. Mind-blowing. They named it right. Natural heaven, because it's heavenly delicious. Okay? This is plant-based. This is made of hearts of palm. I'm like, why haven't I heard about this stuff? Natural Heaven, Hearts of Palm, spaghetti. And not only do they have spaghetti, there's a lasagna, there's a rice, all these. I'm like, whoa. And I'm going to be honest with you. I didn't think it was good. And so when Chris told me about it, I said, well, let me go get some. Ran out and bought it. I actually bought 4 boxes. And I thought, before, it is gluten-free. Yes, it's gluten-free. And I'm like, I've got to try it before I go on and tell my people how good it is. And I'm like, whoa! I made this with a ground chuck and also used like cumin and taco seasoned mix with it. Oh my God, fresh basil. When I tell you, incredibly delicious. I almost slapped myself. And I'm not gonna lie, this is some great stuff. I was about to say something else, but it is really, really Natural Heaven. You can order from their website. And later this week, I'll say next week, there's a code that I'll give where you can get this pasta, or you can go to their website and get it. You can't find it at local stores. Just Google Natural Heaven and you'll see where you can actually get it. But next week I should have the code where you can just log on and get it at like 10 or 15% less than you can get it, I think, in the store. Natural Heaven, paired it with this. Now remember, season your beef. If you're using, if you're vegan, it can be all veggies, but add some cumin. I'll tell you, the reason I think why I was able to stay on keto for so long is because I'm not afraid of spices and herbs. Don't be afraid of herbs and spices, guys. Go to the supermarket or to the farmer's market and walk the aisle of spices and just grab things. They're really, at the farmer's market, they're really, really inexpensive. Just grab things. Just take a day and just go get nothing but spices. And you'll be surprised how impactful your lifestyle will be when it comes to keto or any other plan that you're trying to stay on. And I think that's what helped me a lot. Simply Desi, you know I'm right. And I think being a chef, I'm not afraid of herbs and spices. You know, I'm not at all. And you shouldn't be. And this is a treat. Because I'm a snacker. Sugar-free popsicles. No sugar added. Sugar-free. Now, at nighttime, when I'm looking at TV, I'll eat me 2 or 3 of these. And don't feel bad. So, there are so many snacks. I'm not going to stay on here very long, guys. Because I've been on here long enough. But I got these the other day at Costco. If you like an Almond Joy, this is called Unreal. It's an Unreal bar. It's dark chocolate and coconut. It's a coconut bar. Like an Almond Joy. Sugar-free. And they're good. They're really, really good. Mm-hmm. But I'm gonna sit there and eat the whole container. And I like to use Canada Dry. That's what I'm drinking here. Sugar-free, zero sugar, Canada Dry. And lots of water. And I like to make tuna with dill relish. Duke's Mayo is gluten-free and low carb, low sugar. Or you can use an avocado mayo. Low sugar, low carb, avocado mayo. But Duke's, it's really good. To me, this tastes like a standard regular mayo, because it really is. Just low carb and low sugar. Peanut butter and jelly. I'm going fast, because it's late. Sugar-free, no sugar added, Jif. Now, of course, peanut butter has a natural sugar, but this is no sugar added. Jelly. Smucker's. Sugar-free, no sugar added, sugar-free jam. Sugar-free, you see that? Different flavor. I love strawberry, but I have this in blackberry, cherry, peaches. Everything is sugar-free. And a gluten-free, not sugar-free, but a keto-friendly bread. These are wraps. Aldi. They have traditional. And this is a multi-steam. Beyond Chips. Beyond Chips. For Super Bowl. Oh, this is really good. Super Bowl Sunday, we made all things keto. And you didn't, the guests enjoyed everything I made. We made barbecue chicken nachos. But not just any barbecue chicken nachos. We made barbecue chicken Kicking Country keto nachos, okay? Kicking Country keto barbecue nachos. So make sure you go to Amazon and get yourself some Kicking Country keto barbecue sauce. And it's also available in the TikTok shop, okay? When I tell you, I grilled the chicken, chopped it up, diced it up, and put all sort of incredible things, peppers and onion, jalapenos, sour cream, avocado. Didn't miss a trick, just a beat with these nachos. You didn't feel like you were missing anything. And another chip are Quest chips, but I prefer Beyond Chips, they're the best. But I'm gonna go. So remember to like, follow, and share. And hopefully, I will see you guys again Friday. Because I've got a lot going on this week. I won't stay home tonight because I've got so much going on. Hi, me so Mary. Me so Mary. Thanks for following me, guys. Remember to like, follow, and share. Daryl Taylor. Miss Bougie just purchased the strawberry. Oh, good. That strawberry jam is really, really delightful. And sometimes late at night, I'll crave a peanut butter and jelly sandwich with the sugar-free jelly, strawberry. Of course, I love strawberry. And with the jelly, peanut butter jelly, Jif sugar-free. Oh my God, delicious. And I don't feel bad when I eat the popsicles sugar-free. Oh my God. Okay, so good. So I'm going to go, you guys. I will see you guys very soon. And maybe the next time I come on, we'll cook something on Friday. We'll cook dinner Friday evening. And then maybe Saturday morning. I needed something to drink. So we'll cook Friday evening between 6 and 6:30. And then Saturday morning, we'll make breakfast. Saturday morning, we'll make keto pancakes or waffles or something. We will decide Friday what we're going to cook Saturday morning, okay? When we did the 19-day keto challenge, oh my God, we did keto pancakes. We did keto crepes with berries and, oh my God, incredible things we did all 19 days. I think this was in February that we did a 19-day keto challenge. Yeah, so remember to like, follow, and share Daryl Taylor, Chef Drama from Next Level Chef Season 2, Gordon Ramsay, Naisha Arrington, and Richard Blaze. I'll see you guys again on Friday, 6:30 p.m. Eastern Time. I'm in Atlanta, Georgia. I've enjoyed being in your house tonight, just chatting with you. I was about to say cooking with you, but we didn't cook anything tonight. I'll see you again Friday, and I'll see you then. Until then, I'll see you Friday. The time is 6:30 Friday. Diana 029. See you Friday. Thanks. Remember to like, follow, and share. Daryl Taylor, Chef Drama. I'll see you Friday. Bye-bye.